In this video, we will make two graphs. So these are graphs of these functions. Function of x, so you can say that our y is x square plus 2x plus 1 is first function, and this is our second function. And in this graph, we will learn a couple of things. First of all, how to define x variable, how to define these functions, how to get the function values, then how to plot, then how to change these colors, and how to change these line styles. And also, as you might have noticed, that Scilab graphs don't have font sizes this big. So we will also be changing the font size of x-axis label, y-axis label, and also font size of the figure itself. So then we will put a title to this graph as well. So these are some of the things which we will be learning in this class. Without further ado, let's start. So first of all, we have to declare the variable x, and as you can see here that our x is changing from minus 10 to plus 10. So this is the range of x. We will define x first of all. So in Scilab, we can define x as x equals minus 10 with an increment of 0.1, we go to 10. So this is our x variable. You can also write this in a function if you want, but I'm just using the command prompt so that I can explain the thing step by step. So the first function we have, as you can see, that our first function is f equals x square plus 2x plus 1. We can say that our f1, any variable, is equal to x square plus 2 multiplied by x plus 1. So now this f will get all the values. So our second function is, we can say f2 equals x square minus 2x minus 1. So x square, x raised to the power 2, minus 2 multiplied by x minus 1. So this is our second function. Now we plot the first function. So plot, we are using the plot command, and the plot command is similar, or you can say closer to the MATLAB plot command. So if you are coming from MATLAB background, so you will find this very similar. Otherwise, there are other commands available in Scilab. So we plot x versus f1. So as you can see that we got this plot of our first function. So similarly, we can plot the second function first, and then we will change the attributes of this plot. So let us plot x versus f2. So now we have our both plots here. So now we want to change the color of one to red, and also the line style. As you can see that our line style is x. We are putting x at all the values which we are plotting. First we finish with the plotting, and then at the end I will show you what line styles we have, so you can easily change the line style which you want. So now in order to plot this x and this blue color, what we have to do, we will use the same plot command again. If you want, you can just close this window. So we can close this window so that we get the new window. So we use the plot command x comma f1. Now we will give a third variable here, and which is a string type. So we have to start the apostrophe and then x dash, and then color is red. So let me see whether which color we have in our example. So our plus function has blue color. So we can put blue color with B, and I will show you all the codes for this color at the end. And apostrophe close here, and if I plot now, as you can see, our first function has been plotted in blue. Now similarly, we can plot the second one, plot x comma f2 comma x dash red apostrophe, and now we have our both functions plotted, one in blue and one in red. Now we want to put our x label here, which is x, the value of x. So that can be done in a couple of ways. You can plot your x label, y label, and the title separately. But there is a command which can do this together for you. And we can use that command as well. So Let's first we do with the separate commands. So we say x label, and then we just want to put x. We don't want anything else in x label. So x is our x label. So now we have this x written here. Now similarly, we can say y label. And at y, on y axis, we want to put fx. So we start a string and then fx. And when then we close this string, and now we have our yx rotated automatically. So this rotation is automatic. Now if we compare with this, we still have to write this title. A title, you can write simply title, and then you can again similar fashion graph of functions. Close the string, and now we have this title. And so now we have to put this legend, and in this legend, as you can see that we have statements like x square plus 2x plus 1. So for this we have to write some mathematical equations, and this we will be doing in our legend statement. So you don't have to actually store this in any variable, but I will just store in h1 so that we might need this. H1 equals legend. Legend is the command, and inside this command we have to put a matrix. Here we are having two legends, so it will be a matrix which will have two entries or two elements. So this is a matrix, a row matrix, a row vector. These two are the string entries. So this is the first string, then comma, and then this is a second pair of apostrophes. So you can write first legend here, for example f1 and f2. I can just put a comma here, or better you put semicolon here. Both ways are fine. You can put a comma, you can put a semicolon. If I run this now, these are axis properties here, but there is no error. Now if you look here, we have these legends f1 and f2. So if you had no equations, you can straight away write legend like this. And by default, the legends will be placed on the top right corner, and I will show you how to change this position to any other corners. And now we will write these equations. And to write equations, this is the same statement. You have to put two dollar signs. So I put two dollar sign in both of the entries. So in this way, you don't do any mistake, because this is a similar thing you are doing. So you do it to both parts. So in the first, you want to write x square. So x, then hat, then square plus 2x. Here you don't have to put the multiplication sign, because you are not actually multiplying, you are just writing. So you just write 2x, no asterisk here. And plus 1 is the first function. So it will show you, as you can see that at the bottom it is showing you everything. And now in the second, we write again x square minus 2x minus 1. You put dollar sign, and in the dollar sign you can write the equation as you write in LaTeX, if you are familiar with LaTeX. So now if I enter this, it will again show you axis properties, and we will talk about this later. And now as you can see that we have equations written here. So now we want this to change from this to this position, or probably this position. So for that, what you need to do, you can put a third argument in this legend function. You can say that POS position equals, and let's say 3. So there are a couple of positions available. So I think the 3 is bottom left or top left. So we will see what position this is. So just enter this, and now you can see that the position 3 is bottom left. So position 2 could be this one. So you can try with this. But the best way which I like to do is by using a position 5, because position 5 gives you the option to put it wherever you like. Because sometimes in graphs you don't have an appropriate position in the corner, so you want to put in the middle or at the top of the figure, for example. So in that case you can use position 5. So let us use position 5 now. When I open the graph, it is waiting for me to click somewhere, because now I have this attached with my mouse, the legend box. So wherever you want, you can put it. Now the last thing, as you can see, that we have to increase the font size. To increase the font size, we have to use a handle variable. So handle means identifier of any figure. So any figure has an identifier. So that identifier is called handle. So we will store that handle in a variable, and then we will access axis properties using that variable. So let us say that A is the variable in which you want to store the handle of this figure. So to access the handle, I can say GCA is the command, get current axis. And now we have handle. So now we have access to all the axis properties. So now you have to know what property, what is the name of the variables defined in Scilab for that particular property. So there is a list of properties available. So you have to check in documentation, for example, for font size. So let me show you how to change the font size. Font sizes are available from 1 to 10. So 1 is the smallest, 10 is the largest. So by default, I think it is 2. So I want to make it 4. So how will I do that? I will just say a.fontsize and font, then underscore size. This is the way you will write this. You cannot change this because this is defined in Scilab like this. So you have to change a.fontsize equals 4, for example. And now if I look at the figure, you can see that the font size of the figure has changed. Now I want font size of this title to be changed, and also the X and Y labels to be changed. So to change the X label font size, you will say a dot X underscore label, and then you will put dot and then font size just like before. So you have to put font size. So let us change the Y the similar fashion. Let me clear this. So we can change the Y in a similar fashion. Instead of X label, we put Y label. You can again say a dot title dot font size equals, let's say, 6. And as you can see that our font size has changed. Now the legends are not looking good here. We can use position 5 to put in the middle. And now as you can see that this is busy signal. So it means that it is waiting for us to go to the figure and place the legend. So we go to the figure and we place it here. So now as you can see that now it is done. It is exactly the same which we wanted. These are some of the line styles and colors available in Scilab. So we have used this one, the cross. But you can use any of these. For solid line, you have this dash, similarly colon for dotted line, and so on. So all these options are available. So in the next plotting lecture, we will see how we can modify these distances. These are called x-ticks, and we will learn how to modify these and how to put other values here. And we will be using trigonometric functions to do that.